Well, this is Mr. Oman. We're going to be working on the Keepsake box using Inventor software here for Teen Engineer class. Please open this up in Canvas like I'm showing and download the directions from that link. Okay, these directions will show you exactly what needs to be drawn, and we'll be following those directions on your screen. And you can draw in Inventor software. We're going to be drawing parts, part files, according to the directions. So have each of these open on your screens. All right, so here's the finished product. You don't have to have a Green Bay Packers logo or even use those colors. You can use whatever colors you want on it. These are Mr. Tofar's directions that he made that we're using. Okay, so I'm starting a part file right now. Sometimes Inventor takes a little while to load up. It's a big program. All right, so we're gonna start a 2D sketch. And click on the XY plane, so we're drawing in an upright position. We'll be drawing the back of the box first. The rectangle measures 10 by 4, so I'm going to use the rectangle tool, type 10. Then the tab key on your keyboard will switch to the other measurement, type 4, and the enter key. So that was 10, tab, 4, enter that I just did. I'm going to draw another rectangle down here near the bottom of this piece. This is going to be the cutout between the legs. It's 7.5 long by 5/8 tall. So get a rectangle started approximately in the right place. So 7.5 tab 0.625 is the same thing as 5/8 of an inch, 0.625. Hit enter. Okay, now I only guessed as to where that rectangle was placed there. I still have to move it over. It's 1 1/4 of an inch. So I'm using the dimension tool. I'm clicking between the end of the big rectangle and the end of the little rectangle. And I type 1.25. It moved it over. Now it is for sure correct. I'm going to finish the sketch with the green check mark button. We're going to move on to the extrude command to make it 3D. And I do need to select inside my shape. So I'm clicking right here. With the mouse, it needs to know how thick my board is. The board is 0.75 thick, or 3/4 of an inch. And I'll hit OK. And there's the basic shape of our back piece. We still have to cut out the rabbet cuts on the ends and the groove for the bottom piece yet. So we're going to start another 2D sketch. We're going to put it right on the board, this time right on the face. So click that for me. Okay, we're going to use the rectangle tool again. We'll start in the upper left corner. We'll drag this down to the bottom edge. So it's already 4 inches tall. We just have to tell it that our width is going to be 3/8 of an inch. So in decimal form, that's 0.375. Okay, I'll do the same thing over on the other end. Finish my sketch. Oop, actually, we got one more rectangle to go. We got the groove, so we'll just let's take a guess and draw a rectangle about the right length. We'll fix it with the dimension tool in a moment. Okay, the thickness of that groove is 1/8 of an inch. So 0.125 or 1/8, either one will work. And now we have to get the groove in the right place. I only guess as to where I put it. It's 3/4 of an inch from the bottom. So again, use the dimension tool, pick the very bottom line of the board and the bottom edge of the groove. Click one more time to set it down. You can put it over to the side, that's fine. And I'll type 0.75 or 3/4. And hit enter. So now it moved it to the right spot. We'll do another extrusion to finish things off. Please do all of these three extrusions all in one job here. So notice at this point that it's bringing the material outwards, which is obviously not what you want. You want it to cut inward, so switch to the cut button. All right, now the problem is it's cutting too far. It's going to cut all the way through, so we have to change it to 3/8 or 0.375 as distance A. And hit OK. And you should have a finished back piece. So please do a file save as. Go into your folder, whether it's student share or student home. Whatever the case, make a folder with your name on it. So right click, go to new folder, and you can type in your own personal name. Go inside of that folder, and we can either call it part one. It'd be better to call it back so you know exactly which piece it is. So name it. Once you've saved it, you can close it and start a brand new part. We're going to move on to part number two. Okay, part two happens to be the front of your box. I think the directions say keepsake box back, but that's actually the front. So that's a mistake there. So just like the last one, we're going to do a 10 by 4. So 10 tab 4 rectangle. I zoomed out to see it. Another smaller rectangle, same measurements. 7.5 tab. 0.625. So this time I'm actually using the dimension tool to fix it. It'll get the same job done as if you typed it correctly the first time. And again, feel free to pause this video. I'm going a little bit quick. Feel free to replay anything you want to see again. So I hit the finish sketch check mark. I'm going to extrude the shape again. Now, it's possible I could have drawn that half circle right there and extruded that too. That would have been just fine. So if you want to add that half circle at the top for the thumb hole, I'm choosing to add it here a little bit later. Either way is fine. You can use the circle tool, kind of hover in the middle top edge there. A green dot should show up when you're right at the very midpoint of that line. Type in your 1.25 diameter, finish the sketch, extrude, cut, and zoom in there and pick on that half circle, and hit OK. It'll cut that out for you. Okay, let's draw another 2D sketch on the face of the board, and let's do the ends and the groove like on the last piece. Same measurements. 3/8 of an inch wide, or 0.375 would work. Skinny rectangle, 0.125 wide. Point 0.125 or 1/8. Use your dimension tool to fix the location of that groove, 0.75. And it appears like I might have made a mistake on the groove cut out there. So if you did the same thing as me and the legs are the same height as where the little groove is, feel free to go back and fix that with me. And for now, we'll extrude and do our cutting out here. We'll fix that in just a moment. So 3/8 of an inch extrusion being cut. And you can see I've got a little mistake there that I need to fix. I'm going to go back inside of extrusion 1 to sketch 1 right there. Double click on sketch 1, and I can see there's my mistake. That should not say 0.75. It should say 0.625 or 5/8. There we go. Now it fixes that measurement. Hit the finish sketch button. There we go. It's corrected. So fixing mistakes is that easy. in Inventor. File save as. And let's say this is the front. Make sure it's in the same folder as the previous problem. All right, we're moving on to the left side. Okay, you can see our measurements here a little different. It's 6x4. And the smaller rectangle looks like 4.25 by 5/8, 0.625. And our legs are 7/8, which is 0.875 wide right there. Again, feel free to pause because I'm going pretty quick here. 0.75, 3/4 inch thick. Start a sketch. Let's cut out our rabbit cuts and our groove. And we've also got the peg holes to do this time. So let's do those first. So I'm just going to take a guess as to where those should be. Okay, I do know that they're 1/4 inch, 0.25 or 1/4. Now I'm going to fix the location. I'm going to click the center with the dimension tool, click the top edge of the board, click off to the side. So that's 3 left clicks I just did. And it looks like it's 3/8 inch from the top. And looks like 7/8 from the back edge. So that's an X and Y coordinate. It takes 2 measurements to locate a hole like that. Okay, and we can extrude cut that in, and it goes halfway into the board, so that's 3/8 inch. Or you can go all the way through, that wouldn't hurt either. Okay, now let's cut out our rabbets and our groove. Same measurements as before, 3/8 wide, 4 inches tall. And the groove is 1/8 inch wide, and the length of the board. Go ahead and extrude cut all of this out. And this will be 3/8 inch. All right, and we're all done with that. So let's start our next part. We'll come back to the right side a little bit later. Okay, let's draw the bottom. This might be your simplest part. Following the measurements that are given on your directions. So a 9 1/8. Tab. 5 7/8. So do a 9-1/8. When you type those in, so it doesn't treat it as 91/8. And this piece of wood is only 1/8 inch thick, so 1/8. And your bottom piece is done. Go ahead and save that as bottom. Okay, this is your top piece we're doing now. Draw yourself a rectangle. Matches these measurements. Extrude it 0.75. 3/4. And we need to put a sketch on the ends of it so you can get the holes for the pegs. Okay, find the middle of the short edge and work your way over. You'll see the dashed line kind of guides you if you find the midpoint. It helps you to center that board. That's a 0.25 diameter hole. And we still need to dimension that. From the end to the center of the hole. So 0.438, so 7/16 of an inch. All right, so that peg is going in there 1.5 inches. Half of that is into the outer wall, so we need another 3/4 inch deep hole. You could go deeper, it wouldn't hurt anything, but to be accurate, 3/4 would be your answer there. Okay, let's put the hole on the other side. You can see now that the first hole exists, it kind of shows and you can easily draw right over the top. You can see the hole on the other end. It's easy to match that up. So anyways, extrude that, cut it in 3/4. Again, hit OK. All right, so far it's looking good. We do need to do our roundovers in the back corner. All right, so you can do a 3/8 roundover. Click on those edges, hit OK. I use the fillet tool to make that happen. All right, so make sure you save your work. Call this the top or the lid. Okay, and you can move on to the next part. We need a peg. You only need to draw one of these. We'll put two copies into the final assembly when we get there, but for now, just draw one of these parts. Draw a circle, 0.25 diameter. Finish and extrude it 1.5. So 1.5, hit OK, and you can save that as your peg. All right, so that part is done. And close it. And we're to the end of the directions, so they're all done. So now we have to go back. Let's make a right side wall. Since you've already got a left side, we're going to make another right side, so we're going to come back and finish that. We'll just move the peg hole to the correct corner for this copy. So use the same measurements as the left side wall. So 6x4 rectangle. All right, so this time we're going to be drawing the peg hole in the upper left corner. That's the only difference, but we're going to use the same measurements as we did on the left side piece. So again, 3/8 of an inch down from the top edge and 7/16 from the back edge. I'm sorry, 7/8. 7/8 of an inch. Start another sketch. Let's get our grooves taken care of. I see I forgot to adjust the leg width there. That's a mistake on my part, but yeah, make sure the legs are the correct width, 1 1/4. All right, so moving on. Okay, we're done making parts. So after you've saved that one, okay, our next final phase here, we're gonna be doing something called an assembly. So please start an assembly file, not a part file. In an assembly file, you can bring all of your parts. You can use the place button and you can go get parts you've already made and bring them together. So in my opinion, the hard part is done. Okay, you just have to go get your pieces you've already used, and I'm going to show you how to put these together so they stay locked together like they're glued out in the shop. So bring one of each of these parts and bring two of the pegs. And when you're bringing the pegs in here in a moment, you're just going to click twice on the screen to get two copies. Happen. So here it is. So one click, two clicks. Right there, I've got two copies. Back to place, move on to the next part. So we've got a right and a left, front and a back, top and a bottom, and two pegs. All right, so that's the end of all the place commands. Now we're going to be going into a section called constraining. Okay. You might want to pause and rewatch a few of these things that I do here. This part does take practice. I've done lots of these, so feel free to go back and rewatch if something doesn't make sense. Notice closely exactly which surfaces I'm clicking on. So I'm using the constrain mate tool right now. All right, I just stuck those together. That's the first part. Okay, these can still slide around on each other, even though I stuck them together. You still have a flush, so I notice I've switched to the flush option. I flush the top edges. And now I'm going to switch back to mate. I gotta get in close here, and I have to select these two surfaces to stick together. It's kind of like putting glue on them. If it gives you trouble, like it just gave me trouble, feel free to just restart constrain, reselect your surfaces, and usually it works the second time. Not quite sure why it doesn't always work that first time, but usually the second time I can get it to work. And make sure you hit apply when you're done with each one. All right, moving on, we're gonna stick the bottom edge, bottom piece. So I'm mating, using the mate tool to take that edge. I'm going to go over in here, zoom in real close to the skinny groove of that long wall, stick that right there. Again, that's only the first step. We've got a few to go. To get that totally locked in place, I'm going to switch to flush. Flush is just evening up the ends. Hit apply. Okay, and this thing can still slide up and down. So it is mated and it's flush like we did. We're going to go back. We're going to mate one more time. So quite often it's a mate, flush, mate are the three steps that I'm doing here. So I had to restart constrain there. It wasn't cooperating. This is going to be a little tricky to get into that tight spot. I'm going to mate that surface right there. Okay, so that should be fully locked together, fully constrained. So if you grab onto a piece, everything should come with and not fly apart if it's fully constrained. So that's your test. Try grabbing onto a part and dragging it around to see if it'll stay together. If it comes apart, you have more work to do. For some reason, my box kind of turned on its back, but no, whatever. All right, moving on here. Let's constrain the next part together. Let's do this wall right here, the left wall. Notice where I'm sticking it to. Apply. Switch to flush. Flushing the top edge. And starting constrain over again. Looks like I need to glue the ends of the walls together. It's giving me trouble. Let me start that one over. There's probably a better way to do that than what I did, but one more time. Constrain, mate. That surface to this one. Okay, there we go. Now it gave it to me. So I'm trying to get frustrated if it does that to you. It did it to me as well. All right, that's all locked together. And by the looks of it, my bottom piece might be a little small, or my walls are glued incorrectly. Something's not fitting. Okay, but I'll get this last wall mated and flushed together. So I get flipped over during that process. That's okay. The flush tool can correct it. And apply. So feel free to try more than once if you need to during the constraining process. It's very normal for it to kind of do some goofy things on you. Okay, we're going to switch to the insert tool. I'm going to insert the peg. Now, if it goes the wrong direction, switch the solution button to get it to go the other direction. Make sure you pick the outer part of this circle coming up here, not the inside. There we go. And apply. And same thing, let's grab that, flip it over at the solution button. And you can tell, even though I've mated and flushed everything, you can see something's not fitting quite right here. Okay, that tells you you would need to go back and fix your parts if something doesn't quite fit correctly. You're also welcome to use the materials appearance tool. You can change colors, any colors you would like. Feel free to finish it up. Make it look nice the way you want it to. All right, take a picture with your iPad, a 3D angle, and submit that picture to Canvas. And that's the end.